Hello, hi everybody. My name is Paolo. I'm living and working here in Italy. And as a citizen of this country, I would like to say thank you very much for coming to visit us here in this our country, where one of our characteristics is the hospitality we have. So it's a pleasure all the time receiving first people enjoying what we have, bad things, good things we have. Thank you very much. I'm going to present something I worked on with Bygon from maybe 16 years, and he's developing the technical part of this system, and I was a big part of the developing of this material called Trina, and I would like to show what is Trina, introducing Trina. Trina is a fiber quartz material, and we are going to compare this material with other material used in dentistry. Trina is FDA approved, so can be used in dentistry like a permanent restoration. The composition is 44% resin, 60% is fiberglass, and one of the best characteristics of this material is the flexibility DCS. Can be used like a permanent restoration for single coppings, or little bridges, or bars, or dental and partial. And I would like to show our technical experience with this technique. Trina is so selling like a pack, and have to be designed with this characteristic. Above the coping, we need at least 2 millimeters, so the final restoration should be into 9 to 10 millimeters to provide this big extension of cantilever. Obviously, we have to leave at least 2 millimeters of thickness above the coping, and the machine can be set up to leave this thickness, but sometimes in the lab or in the clinic, doctor is going to reduce this part and make this restoration weaker. The connector should be, as I told you, 7 millimeters square, and the walls of the coping should be at least 0.7 millimeters. Trina can be used for Bygon system or screw retain system, it doesn't matter. Can be milled with a milling machine, and we were lucky to taste these machines over the years. And Bygon is selling this material, as I told you, and we also providing to give you all the information you need to work with this material properly. For example, the burrs, the tools you have to use are diamond, and we provide to give you the number speed you have to use for every single machine. For example, this is one of the most expensive machines Bygon has, is called IMES, but also this other machine can be dry or wet and with their own characteristic. But I confidently can say we started using Roland 5 years ago, and we have 2 Rolands in our products, and they are consistently working every day with no problem. So if they can be milled with the Roland, can be milled properly with all the other systems. There is an extension of Trina, I would like to say, because this is also one of the reasons why I'm using this little silicate on my next cases. And we can use Trina like a framework and can be covered with a little silicate. This is an extension. We are not doing this regularly, but anyway, if some of the people wants to use little silicate above Trina, can be used. Can be also used to make hybrid abutments. We don't do that, but anyway, there is also another chance. And this is one of the first cases we made long time ago where we used the Trinia like a single copy in the ISIS restoration. What I would like to show you now is a video we made 5 years ago, and what we did 5 years ago is a little bit different from what we're doing today, but still the doctor needs to take an impression with this system, and is using the properly impression post with the proper sleeves, and nothing is more easy to take the impression with this system because there is also only a round peg in a right hole, and the impression is has been taken with silicone in a monophase, and this is what's happening on the cleaning part. There is also in this video is shown how the doctor should record the bite and give the bite to the dental laboratory. It's very easy and it's very accurate, so we don't need to ask the patients to come back for take a bite, losing or missing a clinical visit, because it can be made directly to the impression post as shown on this video. In our dental laboratory, to transfer this bite to the models, to articulate the model, is very easy and it's very accurate. And it can be also see end of the presentation how accurate was the bite. The doctor is going to reinsert the temporary and we receive the impression in our lab. We are going to pull the model with a normal technique, and now I'm showing how we can select the abutment and start to make the milling copy. I use this video because I told you also in our little reality we start from this situation and now we move to the other situation. In fact, if you see the abutment we used 5 years ago, they are totally different from the abutment we are using today, saving time and be more accurate. In that time, the abutment have to be milled individually, no more today, because the abutment are already made, and we need to make them parallel each other. As my colleague showed you, we went to scanner and designed this framework with the Acilona system in that period, and the in-lab machine is milling the framework for the Trinia restoration. After the machine milled the Trinia restoration, we in the lab received this fantastic material, very easy to be used. In fact, if you see how easy it is for a dental technician to adjust the margins, it's a dream. The birds can milling the Trinia restoration very easily, and the machine can make the margin very accurate. In that time, is another step over, we needed to pay the Trinia framework, wasting one step. Today, Trinia can be used without opaque, so we can get more translucency with less time. After we opaque this Trinia framework, we are going to apply a composite material. When I start to work with this reality, I had only bad experience with this composite material, but I was lucky to believe on the progress, because today I can say what we can achieve with this material is better or is the same for what we achieved with porcelain. Every step has to be cured into the lab cure lab, and the material has to be used like a paste, and the spatula should smooth this material very nicely without using additionally modeling liquid, because the syringe has already balanced between monomer and the polymeric phase. So if we use too much modeling liquid, at some point we have to repolish with more difficult. So important is using this material properly without using additional monomer. Can be used with the brushes, can be used with a silicone spatula or with a metal spatula. When we finished to build up the restoration, We are going to finish this bridge using the regular boards we use for porcelain. In fact, on the video it showed a stone boards or diamond boards can be used as well. An important step is finishing the case very accurately on the articulator, checking the bite very well, and also finishing a nice anatomy. And we are making a tessitor now, as regularly we do with all our restoration. And we would like Pim Fox to provide the restoration to have his own individual characteristic, making a very nice contour to make the teeth small or accurate, making a baby fissure or embrasure measured instantly, just to make those teeth look like some more natural. And technician should always check what he's doing and applying the normal technique we know since we went to the dental school. All the restoration we're doing are manually polishing. I know sometimes it's easy to use glaze, but the glaze is something that doesn't be stable. It's not stable on the time. So it's much better to polish our restoration manually. They can be shining using several steps. Like I'm showing you now, we are using brushes, silicone brush, and now we are using a paste, with paste and without paste. And this is how the restoration start to be shining. After we finish this restoration, we send everything to the doctor. This case was made in Boston 5 years ago. The doctor is receiving the case, is going to remove the temporary, and look how easy is for the doctor to insert the bridge using the apartment, using the bridge like a dragon. Dr. Murko is the next speaker. She will explain much better this part. After the doctor inserts the bridge, we are going to evaluate what we achieved. And for example, for my point, what we can achieve with this technique is almost the same for what we can achieve using different materials. So I can't say composite restoration is a limitation about the aesthetic, because on the same end, on the same eyes, with the same technology, we can achieve the same result. Doctor is applying some vaseline all around the bridge, and at that time we are going to cement all the restoration with a permanent resin cement. Today, with this new technology, we are starting to use retentive coatings, which is the next presentation. The doctor is tapping the bridge in, is going to remove all the estuary cement excess, and this is how the restoration looks like. Was made in only one day, but normally in America everything is going very fast, no? Which is also good because we can prove what we made can be done also in a short time. This is the full image restoration, and this is the smile line. I don't know your expectation, but for my technician point, when we finish a case, telling the truth about the difficulty, the process we used, and we can achieve this smile, it seems like we are, from my understanding, on the right way to go. Cases been inserted 5 years ago, is still there, patient is happy, and we are going forward with this technique. Now I'm going to show you the last case I made. It was just inserted maybe yesterday or 2 days ago. Who makes presentation knows this part. Always we love to present the last case. And only in this way we can move to the future. So we received this case, this impression. we pull the model, making a silicon gun. This is the model. The patient has three on teeth. And this is something we made in two clinical visits. So we received the impression maybe a week ago, 10 days ago, and we received a bite, and we articulated the case, and we followed to set up the lower teeth following the existing teeth. So we copy the arch, we copy the eye, we copy the position, we articulated the case, so it's impossible to make mistakes because we have a patient's own guide. We finished to set up the lower teeth. The teeth we used are composite teeth. Any kind of composite teeth can be used. And the class of bite was the second class of bite, so we know we have to set up teeth edge to edge. We check the setup we made in a whole direction, and this is what we should do. After we check that the setup is okay, is accurate, we are going to use a silicone guide. Silicone guide has to be used to maintain the teeth position. After this step, we are going to clean the wax from the teeth, and we are going to glue this teeth by snaggling to the silicone guide. And this is very simple to do. Now, this is an important step. Universal abutment are already needed. And what we have to do in the lab is find the right axis of insertion. And we know now you should be within 1.5 degrees. And there is several instruments in the lab can allow you to find the right path. This is the universal coving. And someone is retentive, some other passive, it depends of the restoration. We should be very accurate to produce a racing guide who drives the doctor to find the right abutment position. So we let you a big portion of the racing guide, and then we are making holes all around and relining all the holes near the abutments with this Duralay resin or similar, so the retraction of the resin is very small and the guide is very, very accurate. After we made the resin guide, we have to provide to build up the trinear bar. So we need to leave space for this design, and this is how we can reduce the teeth touching to the covings to achieve the right space to design the trinear bar. As we know, trinear have to be designed with a settling thickness, 2 millimeters at least above the covings, and the connector should be at least 7 millimeters square. This is a scanning of the, this is a scanner of the model with the silicone guide. So the technician can have a clear picture of what he's doing, and what we should do is designing a proper bar for this case. In this case, we provide from our experience to make also mechanical retention for the frontal incisions. For example, some of the cases we made over the last 5 years has some chips on the frontals. If we made a mechanical pivot in the middle of each teeth, this problem can be solved or in a way improved. After we made and created a STL file, we sent the file to the machine. The machine is emitting the bar we designed, and this is how the bar should be received from the machine. Smoothing, no angles, accurate, and is rounded also underneath, because our goal is make a removable restoration, but also give to the patient the possibility to clean the restoration in his own, in his mouth, without removal all the time. So we are avoiding any flanges, and we are trying to make as rounded as possible the bar underneath, touching the gap. As I told you, if you see, the pivots are very well designed into each teeth, and also we are using this product to bonding the composite teeth to the linear bar accurately as possible. This is what the lab should do, be accurate as possible. So we are using silane, number one, and then after the silane, one day we are applying a bonding called CRP number 2. We lat cure this bonding under the lat cure. And this is the way our the doctor should communicate the gum shade to the dental laboratory. Because also the gum shade has its own importance. This is how we bonded the teeth with acrylic resin to the bar. And we removed all the excess because we want to leave acrylic resin in touch with the restoration in the mouth. So we are going to use the acrylic for bonding the teeth, but then after the resin set, we have to remove all the excess. After we made this step, we are going to use another system to provide to reduce the complaints we receive when the people says this restoration is losing vertical dimension because the composite teeth are wearing more than porcelain. The opposite was porcelain. And what we did in this case, we milled the last molars and we designed two little disilicate crowns. We casted these two disilicate and we are going to apply on the last two molars, like two loose stop, two disilicate, little disilicate, to avoid the wearing of the restoration over the heels. This technique is important, especially when the opposing is a porcelain or is a broken teeth. Now we are going forward to finishing and design all the details as we do for the normal restoration, and we use several technique to find the line of the lights or the light of the shades, and I'm showing you now. I'm going to bonding these two Leo disilicate to the linear restoration. I'm using a green power to check if there is a pre-contact. After we check this step, we are going to check the occlusal part and all the teeth are touching, like edge to edge for the second class of bite. Then we went to glaze the two little disilicate. This is the first bag. After the first bag where we applied the shade, then we move to glaze. And as I told you, all our restoration are manually polished. We believe to polish the restoration manually. And we have several steps. We can show you how the restoration can be shining using a manual system. Now, after we finish the polish, we are going to apply a little stain, but the stain we apply is for Italian characteristic of some other people who wants always be making things natural as possible. And this is why we're using a little stain just in the middle of the sulcus. For example, in America they didn't like this stain, so never use a stain on my crown. So sometimes we in Italy are a little complex, so to accurate. Now, after we glazed, we apply the stain on the occlusal surface, we are going to bonding the two disilicate, little disilicate to the restoration. So we are using CRP, bonding agent for porcelain and resin, number one, number two, on the last two models. So this restoration is full made with trinia and dental teeth, except the last two models, where we used little disilicate to prevent the wearing over the time. We are cementing these two crowns, and we are using an oxygen barrier from the company to avoid the contact, the cement with the oxygen. and we are going to polish manually some little margin of extra cement we got, and we ready to check the restoration on our model. So it's a second glass of black. It's finished now. It was like we designed it, and we ready to deliver everything to the dental office. Thank you very much. This is the accuracy of the restoration. If you see underneath is all round, this is the goal. It's not all the time achievable, but this is the goal. Three retentive coating, one passive coating, little desilicate on the back, and all the restoration is made with composite tea. We use the resin only on the lingual area. The case was finished without any trying. So we sent the case to the doctor. The doctor is going to extract the three frontal teeth. And he makes some suture. After this step, he's going to following what we designed on the model. Yeah. Should we have a great cooperation with dental laboratory and a doctor office? It has to be a cooperation. So we sent the guy and the doctor following the sequence, applying the first two universal abutment untouched. They are not touched. So we save time with a better result. After this step, the doctor is going to remove the healing abutment and is going to follow the sequence of the abutment we signed on the model. The doctor here, there is a little margin covered with the gum. So he used just a tiny laser to remove a portion of the gum. And now he's going to bonding the coatings to the linear bar. So the goal of this system, everything works because it's made directly in the mouth. Impossible to do with other systems. So this is why we don't need to make grinding, soldering, welding. How many of you knows about the limitation we have using a metal or zirconia? This is a clearly simple, logical things. I'm not saying something is not understandable. Everything is fixed in the patient's mouth. You're using the own mouth, the mouth of the patient, to bond into the coatings to the trinial bar. And they have to work for sure, 100%, because it's passive, as passive as possible. They are the restoration just inserted, and this is how we finished our case. We only do clinical visit. I think this is a good, another good step to consider. This is was a smile of the best. It was made in our called the dental. We invited the patients to show how easy it was to remove the restoration and insert the restoration, because I like to share this emotion, no? Because it was emotional seeing our lady the day of the insertion showing how easy it was taking it out putting it back. It's a totally different concept from the telescopic. It's a totally different concept.
My name is Silvano.
Oh, thank you for coming. And I would like to know about the feeling you have with this new restoration.
Yes, I am feeling all right. It seems to be my whole teeth.
Okay. Are they light or are they heavy?
They are very light indeed.
Oh, very nice. So, thank you very much for coming to see us today.
It was a pleasure to go.
Okay. What can you say about this restoration? Do you like encouraging to go forward with this technique, or do you think it's better to get towards that?
I want really to encourage everybody to try this new technique.
Oh, thank you very much.
That's all right.
I would like to say thank you. to Byron and Dr. Morgan especially for the opportunity he gave me 15, 16 years ago. We did a lot together. Probably we are near here than when we start. And we hope to move forward again on the following years. And I also would like to say thank you to the guys that every day helps me to work. Grazie.